Hey, so this is an introduction to the character I'll be testing for the use of summonings. And the feats I have are augment summoning, you can see it here, and improved augment summoning. And I got the Sign of Elysium. And furthermore, I have for my enhancements, I've taken Brother Wolf. I did not take Shared Spirit. I could have taken it, I haven't. And then I've taken Harbor Leadership. So this brings my wolf stats to... yeah, this, and if I go do ship buffs, it gets a bit higher, and I've taken all the summoning buffs that the druid has, Tenacious Pack and Unyielding Pack and Long Strider. What I wanted to test was to see if the druid pet could function more or less as a tank on Reaver 1, so this is what I will be testing. Yeah. For the filigrees, I have the Cry for Battle to give it some extra. Yeah. And for the epic destinies, I'm in Primal Avatar, and I've taken Natural Shielding, and I've taken Chill of Winter, because it's a nice debuff. It even works on end bosses. And my own stats are, as you can see here, my cold electricity and my wisdom. My DC for Earthquake is 91. It might not be enough on Reaver 1. I haven't, this life I've only been doing Epic Heart, because I don't have many past lives. I have some, but they don't really help this build. And I got a Sorcerer past life and some Racial past lives. But they don't really help this build. I have no druid past lives. Yeah, that was an introduction to the character. I'm gonna be testing a quest next. I'm gonna take the first Sharn quest, not the underwater one, but the first in Sharn. And see how it goes. Yeah. Hello again. I will try and do Sharn Welcome. I will be using a normal hireling, but I won't be using any of the hirelings you get from the Ultimate Fan Bundles. I'm planning on using the Dryad Elder to test that out, and yeah, then I got, what's he called, Garrett the Sainted, and let's see how it goes. See, my pet stats ends up with this.
Isabeth Tremont waits for you here, atop one of Sharn's lofty towers. She can help you contact Lucien Vaughn. Isabeth tells you to take the elevator up to the terrace, then speak to Lucien Vaughn. Her employer wants you to pass along some information about the storage beacon. You enter the boarding house, an island of quiet in the hustle and bustle of the city. A genial halfling nods to you from behind the front desk. A violent explosion shatters the tranquility of the boarding house and reduces the
two Reapers. This is not gonna go well. And there's a third Reaver. I'm lucky. Well, the Druid is still alive. And since they changed Salt Ray, it's a pretty decent spell. At least at low levels, if you take Master of the Wilds, which I've taken, it gets it to caster level 20, so it does some damage, 1d6 plus 6.
More like an office.
But the main thing of it is the stun, and it's a really nice stun. You can stun almost anything. Well, as you can see, this is definitely not the fastest way to do it. A sorcerer could probably do it much, much faster. But it seems to go okay. Not sure about my spell points. Let's see if I get resurrected. Well, I died, and I'm planning on releasing the wolf and the dryad. Oh no, Druid died. Yeah, I'm gonna try this again. I should have cast Earthquake there. Oh. Yep, so here we go again. Let's try this again, and this time I'll see if I can remember to cast Earthquake. And play a little better, because I'm pretty sure I died because I played bad and not because the build can't do it.
Isabet Tremont waits for you here, atop one of Sharn's lofty towers. She can help you contact Lucien Fong. Isabet tells you to take the elevator up to the terrace, then speak to Lucien Fong. Her employer wants you to pass along some information about the Stormreach Beacon. You enter the boarding house, an island of water. city. A genial halfling nods to you from behind the front desk. A violent explosion shatters the tranquility of the boarding house and reduces the elevator.
Of death is not landing. This is safe. 86. Yeah.
This looks more like an office than a boarding house. Vaunt has rented this entire operation and transformed it into his place of business.
I've taken off empower and maximize because I was afraid I wasn't going to have enough spell points. But I still have my SLAs powered and maximized. Try this again. Well, that didn't go as planned, but yeah, I survived. Good thing casting regeneration before fight. And the dryad died. That the wolf doesn't do a whole lot of damage. not sure if the if it's the spell penetration or the DC. I got uh, 18 in spell penetration bonuses. Yay, a shrine.
I envy you, soldier. You get to sleep after all you've done.
As you can see, the Druid survived. I'm not sure if that's enough. I mean, but at least it can cause a distraction for your enemies and take up some of the aggro and take it away from you. Yeah, I'm not sure if it's worth it. Speaking for. As you can see, the dryad and the wolf survived. They take away some aggro from your hireling or from That could be really nice, but I'm still not sure it's worth spending 2 feet and yeah, 3 filigrees, a lot of enhancement points. Then again, it is a sort of a first lifer, and being able to solo. And being able to solo this one on Reaper 1, I think it's really okay. But the builds can probably do that too. As I don't have many epic past lives, I don't have energy criticals, so my crit chance could be a bit higher, but as you can see, this takes a long time. Yeah, it can be done.
The figure on the sky coach ahead matches the description of Lucien Vaunt. He seems unruffled by the attack.
I have a message for you,
says Vaunt.
The beacon belongs to me now. I paid the Boromar clan good money to get it, after all. Don't think
so. That was a test of if it's worth it spending all that on summonings, and you be the judge of it. Remember, it's sort of a first lifer. With regards to Reaper enhancements, this is what I got. Yeah. Hope you enjoyed the video. Take care.